My name is Hilia Ipinge. I'm coming from Namibia. The problem brought me here with a severe pain at my back. This is my medical from Medipak, Namibia.
Here on the screen, we're looking at this medical report from Ongwendiva Medipak Diagnostic Radiology. It's a medical report from Namibia for Lady Hilia Ipinge. This is where she was referred by Dr. Marcel to have her lumbar spine examined. And when they did so, they found several abnormalities here concerning her lumbar spine. So in conclusion, the doctors noted that she has got a lift, meaning previously she underwent a surgical operation on her back at L4, L5 and L5S1. And also she has got persistent neuroforaminal L4 and L5 nerve compression. This is what is causing her the severe pain in the back for these 6 years. Dr. Precious Champiti signed to confirm this. That's the Ipinge, police officer. She's a police officer from Namibia, receiving healing in Jesus' mighty name. The Lord Jesus Christ is working upon her back, mending all the bones in Jesus' powerful name.
Brother Pango, you're free.
Thank you, Jesus Christ. Once the sun sets you are free indeed. Police officer Ipinge has been declared free. She's turning her neck, checking what Jesus has done for her.
Thank you, Jesus, for healing me. Thank you, Jesus, for healing me. Thank you, Jesus, for healing me. All right, John. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, man of God.
Good morning, church. My name is Leoke Tsohitsema from Botswana. The problem that brought me to Kakande Ministry is a problem of severe back pain after operation. I was operated and I'm due for another operation. Here is the medical report. I was operated in Cameroon Private Hospital.
Here on the screen is this medical report from Bokamoso Private Hospital. It's a medical report for Lady Goisemang. Okay, this way, here is where she was attended to by Dr. Jose Enrique Valderia. Here, the doctor is writing to inform us that this lady was operated upon in November the 19th, 2021 by Dr. Roland. And thereafter, she continued to complain of severe lumbosciatic pain, mostly affecting the left leg, causing a gait problem. Her walking is not right. So when they checked her with the MRI, they noted lithesis grade 1 at L5S1. This slippage of the discs, and therefore with severe foraminal stenosis at this level bilaterally. So the doctor suggested that this lady needs to undergo a second surgery to do decompression for L5S1. And by that time, they were pending her decision to accept or refuse the surgery. And the doctors went ahead to examine her because the condition of the back went on worsening. So in village imaging in Botswana, they examined her. This is an MRI of the lumbar spine report for Sister Lekediswe Goisemang. Here she was attended to by Dr. Gosi, who referred her there. When they examined her lumbar spine, they noted many, many abnormalities, whereby, first of all, they noted she has got grade 1 spondylolisthesis. She has got slippage of the discs at L5S1 level. They noted levoscoliosis of the lumbar spine. They noted post-laminectomy defect, meaning that after the operation, she has got a defect at L3, L4, and L5 levels. And they also noted various disc bulges at L2, L3 level, L3, L4 level, L4, L5 level, causing mild to moderate bilateral neuroforaminal stenosis. And also they noted broad-based posterior protrusion and bilateral facetal arthropathy at L5, S1 level, causing mild spinal canal stenosis and severe bilateral neuroforaminal stenosis. All this impinging on the bilateral exiting nerve roots. This is being confirmed by Dr. Chivran, is a consultant radiologist. So this is the state of the lady. You can see that she sits on a special cushion because the pain she has is so severe. healer's name is Jesus Christ. Watch, brethren, the watch is touching the life of this lady. The floor she goes.
Be healed in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Father, thank you. We bless your holy name. Thank you, Jesus. Rise up and go your food.
Sister Lekodiso has been declared free. She has risen up. Hallelujah! Clap, clap, clap!
What is now? What is the problem now?
Oh, my name is Leogin Tsowitziman from Botswana. I was operated in 2021. It became worse. I could not walk. I couldn't drive. I was driving. I went to the doctor, and then they said they were suspecting mild failed operation. So there were a lot of things they were saying. A lot of things. When they operated, they opened this, they fused the three bones. They opened again here. They wanted to go in between to operate again, but the machine failed. Then they said the blood vessel was also bursting. A lot of things. Man of God, I suffered.
Why are you crying now?
It's tears of joy.
In Botswana, when you have joy, you cry.
Clap your hands for Jesus Christ for this wonderful miracle. She's a new creation. Clap your hands for Jesus Christ.
Lady Grace Monk, a medical personnel from Botswana, was overwhelmed by the instant healing that she received from Jesus Christ. Be blessed as you listen to her wonderful testimony the following day.
My name is Lewekedi Tsohitsiman from Botswana. The reason I came to the Kakande Ministries was the reason of severe back pain following being operated. The pain became worse. So this is how it started. I have two of my kids that I did a cesarean section. So when the pain started 2015, it started on my right, and they suspected that because they were doing the cesar, maybe they had to impinge one of the nerves with the needle. So now the pain started radiating from my right side to my left side. So there was a scan that was done, and they just said, there are just some white matter disease, of which they said maybe it was due to inflammation in my body somewhere. So they left it like that. So it became worse. So I started having difficulty in sitting for long, difficulty in walking. But being me, I was still wearing some stilettos because every time I wear stilettos, I will feel a little bit better. So we left it like that. 2 years down the line, they did x-ray. They said everything is normal. The bone density is fine. So, but we are just finding a small curvature somewhere towards the sacral part. That's your nature, is just like that. It became worse. I went to a doctor. I work in a hospital, so it was easy for me to approach them. I'm a pharmacist by profession. So I told one doctor, I said, I want you to do MRI. He did some MRI. I went to a private hospital. Then after 2 days, I went to pick my report. Because I'm able to read what the doctor said, I looked at it and I cried before I could tell anyone because I could see. So I sent it to one of the bone doctors, and he started asking me what's happening. My legs were now becoming numb. It was hot, like I was feeling hotness both sides of the legs. So he said, now that you have the numbness of the two legs, and at the same time you are feeling hot, now you are going to be paralyzed. You have to do it quickly. I didn't even like think about this operation or what. My thing was like, I want to see myself in good shape. So within 2 weeks, I was operated on, 2021. This is the first operation here, the 19th of November. So here, they were fixing L3 to L5. And then here, they now went opened in front. The intention was to go in between the skin and the flesh to fix the remaining two ones, L5 and S1. So this is where they were fixing. This is the first one and this is the second one. But this is when I was removing the staples, because they closed the skin with the skin staples after a month. Then they gave me a lumbar corset immediately after I was discharged. So this one, I left it home. After 4 months of being home on sick leave, I went back to work because I was now fearing for my job. Like after 6 months, I'll be put on half salary. So I went back to work. When I reached there, I could not walk. I was deteriorating. They had to put me on 6 months half day. I'll work from 7:30 to 12:30. I work in the office mostly, though I'm a pharmacist. So at lunch, I will sleep. I had a fleece, I had mattress, so that at least I try to relax the muscles. Then after 6 months of half days, they now started alternating days. Like Monday is half day, Tuesday is full day, another just like that. Mind you, in the morning when I go to work, I feel a little bit better, I'll be walking. But half day, I'm unable to walk completely. So it continued. By June, they said, no, let's do post-MRI to see what happened. That's when we did the report. And now L2 up was affected. They said both of these nerves, that's how I was working like this, both of these nerves were now affected, like the blood supply was now low to the legs. They said second operation. I said, I'm not yet ready to do second operation. They say, go and think of it. I continue doing physiotherapy. So when I've done physiotherapy today, it's a little bit better. I do physiotherapy Monday, Wednesday, Friday. It's better. After 2 days, back to zero. So I've been doing physiotherapy, trying to probably extend the time or waiting for God's will, because he said at his perfect time, his will be done. So it was not my time, I believe it was God's time. So I kept on postponing until physio 2-3 weeks back was like, if we continue doing this, now we are going to damage everything. So better take a decision and operate. So as I was struggling, I have a neighbor who came here last year. So she called me and she was like, I'm very concerned about you. Why don't you look for money? Then I take you to Kakande Ministries. I said, I will see. That's what I told her, because although I'm a Christian, my spirit had not allowed me to say, just go. I will just go through YouTube. I saw the ministry. I saw the man who had the same condition and taking the same tablets that I was taking. He came here, he testified. I said, I will tap and my time will come. I will watch for like 1 hour watching the clip. So September was the beginning. I went to my neighbor. I said, now I'm ready to go. Remember, I was living on medication for 2 years. In these 2 years, I developed other conditions. For 2 years, I've been living with depression. This tablet is for depression. It's called fluoxetine. This one is for painkiller. I was supposed to take it 3 times a day. It's a combination of 2 drugs, tramadol and paracetamol. It's in the lines of bromorphine, the opioids. This one also is Adcodol. It contains codeine. It's also in the same line with this one. It has also paracetamol in it. This one is called gabapentin. It's for the nerves, because the nerves were compressed. Now they needed to release it. And now I have this one, baclofen. The muscles were responding. So every time I get a touch on my muscles, they contract. So as they contract, they pull my legs. So now this one is a muscle relaxant. Don't mind, I'm a pharmacist, so that's why I'm able to say them like that. And now, because I'm taking a lot of them, they said this one, you end up with ulcers. They had to add this one. It's for ulcer. Because of the nerves again being affected, there is another one, neurobion. It's a combination of 3 vitamins, 1, 6, and 12. So all this we're trying to make at least the body can function a bit. So this is what I was doing, brethren. I was supposed to take them 3 times a day. But because they were not working for me, I'll take the first dose and the second dose. I'll take 2 Tramacet, 2 Gabapentin, 2 Baclofen. Then I take the Comicardis, Omeprazole, plus this one. There will be around 11 in the morning. That is the only time I can function for at least 5 hours. Or else I won't. You will see me walking the way I was walking on Saturday. And I was sitting on this. This is a sponge. What it does, because there was impingement of the nerves, it absorbs the pressure. I wasn't supposed to sit on a hard object. The hard object will now put more pain on my back. So this one was absorbing pressure. The lumbar corset was to align this bone so that I am straight. I'm not supposed to bend. Then I have another one which says in the car is a headrest cushion. So that one was also making sure the whole entire body is straight. There isn't no way I can make my operation touch the hard object. Or else the muscles will be excited and I had the contraction of those muscles. So Saturday, I had the opportunity to be on the prayer line. Man of God prayed for me. As you saw the clip, the rest is history. Because I wasn't able to do this. From here down, it was always, it was just contraction. So when I woke up from the ground there, the first thing I went to was, I had a way of waking up, actually, because there was a certain way that the physiotherapy told me, when you wake up, do this. So it was like, I'm now used to the way I should wake up. I wasn't supposed to. Like you saw, I woke up straight. I wasn't supposed to do that. So when I woke up, I'm like, there wasn't any pain, like something wasn't telling me that this is the way you should wake up. I just woke up like straight from the floor and I did this and I'm like, ah. So this is what I used to tell them at work. When I'm not able to walk, I'll tell them the gearbox is stuck at gear 1. Because even I will be, this one, I get a gearbox to do this. So I'll be doing this. Yes. So, when I checked the gearbox on that day, the gearbox, you know, from 1 up to 5. Wow. Because I didn't start doing this, kneeling down and doing this, just to be careful that I do not do anything fun. So I really thank God. I really thank the presence of God in this place. Giving thanks also to the man of God, Prophet Samuel Kakande, for praying for me, for availing himself to be used by God to pray for us. Two years since I got operated, I wasn't able to run.
Glory be to Jesus Christ.
I'm a sports person, by the way. That's how I walk like this. I wasn't supposed, I couldn't jump, 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 jump.
Let us clap for Jesus Christ.
So I wasn't able to do this. Yeah, because for now, they fixed these bones. Like, they were telling me, if we go down, then you will not be able, well, the stiffness increases. So Raring, we are not going to be going down again more and more. But now I can do this. Wow. I couldn't do this. I was doing this. This is how I used to do my gardening. Or even mopping. If I become tired, I will mop down. Or even sleep on the floor to mop. I will help my patients, see them healed, advise them. But then the following day is me. I will tell them stop so that I take my tablets. I will take them to the doctors. I see them healed and I'm like, my God, where are you? In the morning when I wake up from my bed, I wouldn't be able to wear my shoe. I'll have to sit down on my bed. I will do this. This is how I used to sleep, so that the bone is in line. If I have to sleep on my side, I turn. And then I take a pillow, I put it like this, so that it become aligned. The spine is aligned. So today I'm thankful to the God of Prophet Samuel Kakande, and I'm thankful to the church at large. Glory belongs to God. So this is how I used to sit. I'm having that cushion here, like this. This thing, the operation should not touch the chair. So most of the time, I'll have to be like this. And then I balance with my legs here. So I cross my legs like this so that I am straight. If I get tired, I move forward and then I do this. The weight here has to be on the chair, not down, on the affecting the nerves down there. So even when I try to drive, one of the hand has to be like this, and I drive with this one. And it has to be automatic, that 5 kilometers that I used to drive. So this is the story of my past, because now I'm living in the present. I'm not going for a second operation, so I'm going back to work. I have not even called a single one. I want them to see the miracle themselves, because they will not believe. But I want those tomatoes to know where God is real. And with my testimony to Botswana, I know they know me. Even when I left, I said, let me go and seek the face of God. So I want them to know that God is real. He is a miracle-working God. He is always there. He's omnipresent. Wherever you are, he's always there. So, Botswana, I did not pay to be prayed for. I was not guided on what to say here. So no one took me to a certain place and say fake or what. Botswana, I am a living testimony.
Glory be to Jesus Christ.
Since I left on Saturday, I have not taken any medication. So this is what was happening. Because I was used to take the depression medication at 10. So after 10, the negative thoughts will start popping in. Also part of the reason I was admitted, go to the psychiatric hospital. I had the thoughts that, why am I living? Haven't I suffered? Is it not enough? So I will even devise a way, because I know the lethal doses of those drugs. I know if I take this amount and I take this, I'll sleep forever. Or if I take this one and take this one, if I take the maximum dose, I will do this. So every time I think of that, something will like prevent me, but I had the edge. So since Saturday, I haven't taken my depression medication. I'm okay. I don't have any negative thoughts. I'm just me, you can see, just me. Batswana kolapeng o ke meske molaetsa wa me modimo ke modimo kana kotsope modimo ga o ka ke wa golatha me modimo ga o thaole ke modimo wa rona rothe o gongwe le gongwe ga o le nteng me ga o takwana o te o le muimana meaning gore come here expecting that I'm going to receive a miracle. Knowing what I'm going to give birth. I've given birth, the new me. So, kwalelenteng le tsihela gore modimo ke modimo go thokana le tumelo ka gore ha ke ntse ha le ke ne ke itse gore ha ke tswaha ke tabo ke taboga ka ha o tle o ta molemong wa Setswana o ta modimo ka tumelo. Amen. Glory belongs to Jesus. Amen. Father, I thank you. I thank you for the healing, man of God. I thank you for allowing yourself to be used by God. And I promise God that I will continue selling the word of God, telling them how good Jesus is. Jesus is for everyone. It's not for so and so. I have seen the miracle working Jesus in my life. I am a testimony. Glory belongs to God.
My name is Eric Munyasia. I come from Kenya, but I work in Kigali, Rwanda. The problem that brought me here at Kakande Ministries is the problem of my left knee. I had an injury while playing basketball when I was still in high school. I went for an operation, but it wasn't properly done. So ever since, I've always had weakness in my left knee. This is my medical report from Buiza Medical Clinic in Kigali.
Here on the screen, we're looking at this medical report from Buiza Medical Clinic and Diagnostic Center. That's from Kigali, where the brother works from, like he has informed us. It's a medical report for Mr. Wanyonyi Eric. Here they are giving us a report after they took x-rays of his left knee, for he was complaining of this pain in the left knee with the history of the injury he got. So upon examining him, they noted that he has got patellar ligament ossification, stroke calcifications, all these are hardenings within the knee, and they also noted patellar dislocation. There's dislocation within the knee. All this being confirmed by the medical imaging specialist, Kaitesi Isabel. These are now 35 years. Brother Eric has got difficulty in walking, squatting. today his encounter with the Lord Jesus Christ will not leave him the same again. All the pain in his knee is being flushed out. Behold how he's being driven to his miracle. Hallelujah! Clap, clap for Jesus Christ.
Thank you, Jesus. 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 I'm healed. Thank you, Jesus, for healing me. Thank you, Jesus.
Put your hands together for the Lord Jesus Christ.
Mr. Wanyanyi Patrick, a Kenyan working in Rwanda, suffered for 35 years. But after the prayer, he was made a new creature in Jesus' name. Listen to his testimony to God's glory.
My name is Eric Munyasia Wanyonyi. I'm originally from Kenya, but I live in Kigali. I've had the pain in my knee since I was 16 years old. I was playing basketball in high school, and I got a dislocation of the patella and a fracture of the patella as well. And so I went to hospital. They did an operation, but they didn't fix it properly. I tried to complain to my dad. I told my dad, please, I'm still feeling pain in my knee. He told me, my son, that's all I can afford for now. You continue with your school. So I continued my studies, and I finished all level. I remember my colleagues whom we were with in the games, some of them got sponsorship. They went abroad. Some were taken by big corporate companies and were given jobs. And I could not get a job. So I had to go to another profession and start looking for new opportunities. So I managed to join the hospitality industry. And I've been working in the hospitality industry now for the past 30 years. Yes, I'm 52. So the past 2 years, I've been getting a lot of pain on my left knee. I start normally work, we start at around 6 in the morning, and we might finish at around 10 or 11 at night. So that means a lot of time on your legs. All this brings a lot of pressure. And for the past 2 years, I've been doing maybe 6 hours. I have to take a break and then come back again. So it all impacts on my performance. And I've been getting difficulties even at work. They feel maybe I'm not producing as much as I should be doing. So I got to know about the Kakande Ministries on the YouTube. I was just checking like new messages and stuff like that. And I managed to see what is happening in Kakande Ministries. Early this year, my sister came here. She came here she wanted to go to Canada. She had worked for Kenya Airways for a long time, and she wanted to relocate. So she said she wants to go to Canada. She came here to see the prophet. The prophet prayed for her, and through the blessings of our Lord Jesus Christ, she managed to get her visa to go to Canada. As we speak now, she's in Canada. She's working in Canada through the prayers that she got here at the Kakande Ministries. After getting her testimony, I felt like I am delaying. I'm the one who's delaying. I don't want to get my deliverance. So I called my brother 2 weeks ago, and I told him, my dear brother, the pain I'm having, I can't wait anymore. Me, I'm going to Kakande Ministries. Are you ready to go? He said, if you are going, I'm going. And by the grace of God, the next day when we came here, my encounter with the man of God, when I was called to the prayer line, I was seeing everybody else falling down, and I'm like, now this tall man falling down, how is it going to be? I was questioning myself, is it going to happen? I was really worried. So luckily, man of God saw the pressure I had, and he said I was not going to fall down. So you can see mine, I was just going round nicely, and you know. Before I go on, I think I'll give my brother the opportunity to just describe my experience.
My name is James Munyasia. The man next to me is my big brother. He's had the knee problem for when I was 5-6 years old. I'm now 40. So being a young brother, I had to drive a lot. Because he'll drive a short distance, then he'll be like, I'm done. So going up country, I'll drive for 8 hours, 9 hours. He's just on the passenger seat. So I'm happy now that the deliverance has been done. He's been healed. He's also going to drive when I'm seated on the other side. And yesterday, after Saturday prayers, we took a long walk. And I was waiting for him to complain about his knee. He didn't complain. We walked for almost 2 hours yesterday.
I want to demonstrate, church, that I was not able to bend. I can bend nicely. I can go down. I can go down like this. Before, I couldn't do this. I couldn't. I can fold this. I can fold this. I can fold this. I can fold this. I'm a sportsman, but I couldn't do sports. It's a shame. So I'm happy that I can now get back to shape. Yeah, I can run. I can walk around. And I walk confidently, so I'm not worried. I'm in the house of God. I can display myself properly. You can see me, very confident, happy for Rwanda. Here I am. I can stretch. I can run. I can run. I'm super fit. My second testimony was, having grown so old, I was having difficulties. When I go to the bathroom, I could not use the bathroom. If I'd go there, I would spend 10 minutes waiting for the pressure to come. We are on a bus trip. We are going to Kigali. We've stopped. It's only 10 minutes. You go to the bathroom, you stand there, others are coming, out. Me, I go there, nothing happens. It's very frustrating. So I look around, I'm like, what's going on? So I wait till the last minute, that's when it comes, and it just comes a small dot, dip, and it stops. I had this problem for the past 2 years. I could not go to the bathroom and urinate properly. I would get pressure that I'll stay the whole day for it to build up so it can get something to get out. Now, the first 2 days, I'm feeling like a young man. Yes. After the man of God, Prophet Kakande, prayed for me, I feel so relieved. I can use the bathroom, and I feel like a young man.